The island state of Madagascar is located on Africa's east coast. While it may not be noticeable at first glance, Madagascar is among the poorest nations of the world. Hardly anyone here has a regular employment, which for us is the norm. And the island has massive environmental problems. Some 90% of Madagascar used to be covered with forest. Today, it is just 10%. Most of the forest has been destroyed by slash and burn agriculture, also to develop new fields for rice or cattle. What's more, almost everyone cooks with wood or charcoal. Only 5 out of 100 households have electricity. The loss of the forest also represents the loss of unique plants and animal life, some of which has gone irretrievably. Some 21 million people live in Madagascar, and this number is estimated to grow rapidly in the coming decades. And with that, the number who contribute to deforestation, because collecting wood is their livelihood. These are often children. The carbon offset project from My Climate and the partner organization ADIS reduces deforestation and CO2 emissions through wood-saving ovens and solar cookers. The wood-saving ovens are produced here in Fianarantsoa. They are made from clay, which is plentiful here. Serge is one of 135 permanent employees. Each month, around 2,600 cookers are produced. They look like this. Radu gives the clay housing the final polish. To finish, they are given a protective metal casing. Lunchtime, break in the courtyard. The employees at ADIS feel well looked after. They say the organization takes care of health insurance, pension and school fees. This is not a given in Madagascar. In total, thanks to ADIS, almost 250 people have a regular income, nearly half of them women. In addition to the salaried workers, many suppliers and retailers also benefit from the project, and almost all of them have families. ADIS reaches many more people than its employees. Serge worked as a teacher. The money wasn't enough for him to start a family. Thanks to My Climate and ADIS, he can afford a home and is now a father. Serge's wife Fania recommends the ovens to her friends, because they don't just save wood. They also produce less smoke than conventional cookers, whose smoke causes respiratory illnesses and 1,000 deaths each year in Madagascar alone. Radu and his wife Eleonore use several ovens at once. Eleonore is economist but doesn't have a job. Radu broke off his management studies to take up a job with ADIS. A secure position with a fair employer is highly valued. His neighbors are interested in his solar cookers. Radu explains to them the relationship between sun and energy and talks about the fight against deforestation. Restaurant owner Jeanne has been using cookers from ADIS for many years and in that time has only used a sixth of the coal. Ideally, Jeanne would like to sell the ovens herself, since so many customers ask her where they can buy one. They are available at 7 ADIS centers across the country and at markets like this one, where Félicien brings the cookers directly to the public. He explains the different models to them. 90% buy the efficient wood and coal cookers because they can be used across the whole island. Solar cookers are used mainly in the sunny south or as secondary cookers. This woman is a cook and knows why she is buying the oven. It has a 3-year guarantee and an efficient cooker uses 50% less wood or coal. She wants to use the money she has saved to pay for her children's schooling. Each cooker sold generates funds for a reforestation project run by the church organization Vujama. Many of the over 200,000 trees in this forest were planted by children and their parents. The people here are very proud of their trees and they understood how important they are for climate protection. Hence, there is no illegal woodcutting. Ardis makes sure the next generation understands the situation. Félicien and Aristide talk to school children about environmental protection and saving wood. Hard to believe, the sun drives the fan. And you can cook without fire.